In the previous movie, we created some finger controls to manage more complex compound motions. In this movie, we'll add the ability to raise, lower, and roll the palm from side to side. Start by opening the file Character Rigging, Part 30 Start, or by using your own file from the previous lesson. A palm raise control will make common motions like pushing off of objects or standing up at a table very easy to animate. The technique for rigging this is very similar to the reverse foot rig we built in Part 19. First of all, we need to connect the control palm to the result palm using the connection editor. Connect both the rotation and translation. Next, we'll create a trio of locators. Remember, for the foot, these represented the heel, ball, and toe, as well as inner and outer foot pivots. In this case, they'll represent the inside, outside, and middle pivots, so rename them appropriately. Now position them such that the inner and outer pivots lie just outside either side of the palm, and the middle pivot lies right on the middle finger's base joint. In the outliner, parent these locators in the following order: inner palm, outer palm, and middle palm. Now duplicate the result hand and delete all its children. Rename it left hand base const joint and parent it under the middle palm locator. So what happens if we parent constrain our control hand to this? Well, we don't quite get what we want. While the locators do allow us to roll the palm, the fingers aren't staying planted in place during these rotations. From previous lessons, we know that to keep joints planted, we need to constrain them using IK handles. However, if we create an IK handle for each of the fingers, we'll completely ruin our existing controls. To facilitate this, we're going to create a new joint structure specifically to accommodate our needs. Duplicate the left pointer 1 compound control joint. In this new chain, parent the last joint to the first and delete the rest of the duplicated children. Rename them left pointer straight start joint and left pointer straight end joint. Now create an IK handle between these two joints using an IKSC solver. Rename the handle and effector appropriately, and group the handle into a left hand straight handle group. Parent the left pointer 1 compound control joint under the new start joint. Rotate one of the pivots again. If we turn on the visibility of the control hand, notice how the pointer finger stays in place. That said, the result hand, on which the proxy geometry is parented, doesn't follow. This is the result of a space issue. If we select the first pointer finger compound control joint, we can see the root of the problem. Even in this rotated state, it has no rotation values. This is because these rotations have been absorbed by the new straight start joint we created on top of it. However, our result hand is missing this particular joint, meaning our control finger and result finger now exist in different spaces. To realign them back to the same space, duplicate the left pointer 1 straight start joint and delete its children. Rename it left pointer straight joint and reparent it to the left pointer base result joint. Then parent the left pointer 1 orient joint under it. Using the connection editor, link its rotation to that of the left pointer straight start joint. Now if you try rotating on the pivot locators again, the pointer finger stays straight even as the palm moves. Repeat the process to create straight joint functionality for the other fingers, placing all their IK handles into the left hand straight handle group. Once again, the thumb presents a somewhat special case. Notice how we've set up the straight joint just above the orbit joint in the hierarchy. This is because we want the thumb to bend at the orbit joint during a palm rotation. With the palm functionality working, let's create some custom attributes to control the rotation of these pivots. Name the first one Palm Raise, and set its minimum to negative 90 and maximum to 90. Open the Set Driven Key window and load the left hand control as the driver and middle palm loke as driven. Set a key between the Palm Raise attribute and the locator's Rotate Z attribute. Now set Palm Raise to 90 and rotate the middle loke's z-axis. Notice that a positive rotation actually bends the palm downward. However, since it would probably be more intuitive for a positive palm raise to be upward, we'll actually set the rotate z-attribute to negative 90, and then set a key. Now swap the palm raise and rotate z-values and set another key. Now add a side roll attribute with a minimum value of negative 90 and a maximum value of 90. Load the inner palm loke and outer palm loke as driven. We'll use the side roll attribute to drive the inside and outside locator pivots. Set a key on both pivots' rotate X values. At a side roll value of 90, rotate the outer locator negative 90 degrees and set a key. At a value of negative 90, rotate the inner locator 90 degrees and set another key. Now you can rotate the hand side to side using this one attribute. Hide all the pivot locators and the left hand straight handle group. Let's also group all the controls together into a left hand control group and parent constrain them to the left hand base const joint. This way they'll follow the palm. There's one final bit of cleanup we need to perform. Due to the addition of the IK handles, our hand control's spread has been altered. We'll need to adjust for the extra influence by setting new values for the spread at 10 and negative 10. That does it for these custom hand attributes. Remember that this is not an exhaustive list. If your animators request additional finger or palm controls, you can add them to this hand rig using the techniques you've learned in past movies. In the next movie, we'll attach our hand to the arm and then clean it up using our rigging checklist.